Hi, my name is Magdalena.
And I'm Joanna.
And we are going to interview you, so let's start with the first question. So, could you tell us a little about yourself?
About myself?
Mm-hmm.
My name is Jakub. I come from Rzeszów in Poland. I was born here. I'm 34 years old, currently living in Rzeszów. 1 month ago I came from abroad for good. And since 1 year I'm running business in Rzeszów, trying to get it large, and trying to get it smooth, and looking forward for the future.
Okay. And what are your hobbies?
My hobbies? I do like cars. I do like cars a lot. I do like off-roading, spending some time when I can on traveling into the mountains with a 4x4 car, getting quiet and exploring. Bieszczady Mountains currently.
Mm-hmm. So we read a lot about your career and about your education. And could you tell us why, what was it like going to school in Belgium?
What was it like going to school in Belgium? So originally I didn't want to go. It was a university program, Erasmus. But before I go, I was very much attached to the city, to the local community. My family was here, everyone was around. I liked that very much. I was also attending university in Poland. But then this opportunity came, and it was my mom who convinced me, and my wife, at that point my girlfriend, who said, try it, let's see how it goes. And I did go there. And I think it was brilliant. It was a breakthrough in my life. We've changed a lot. My life changed a lot since then. I have seen not only Belgium, but a different approach to learning, to tutoring, to experience science in a completely different way.
Mm-hmm. And why did you want to work in Britain?
Again, I started my career by going to Germany. I used to work in Ford Motor Company on a contract basis. And then, I know it will sound crazy, but again, my wife, she didn't speak German. So we decided to get equal opportunities, and I've asked for transfer to Ford in UK. And that's how it started. I didn't have like a big master plan of going from Germany to UK or like constantly being abroad, but it happened. We've got a great time there and we really enjoyed it.
And what is it like about working there?
Well, abroad, generally.
Yeah.
Probably nowadays it's about the same. If you are working in a big company, in a corporate company, the work culture will be the same. If you're working in a small companies, I don't know. I don't have too much comparison because my real job, first real job, is was abroad. So I didn't get the too much comparison between Poland and Germany and UK. Germany and UK is very similar.
Okay, and did you always know you wanted to set up your own company?
Difficult question. I don't think so. It came with the time. It came with a learning during the life. You clarify what you want to do, and then you get it.
And what problems did you face at the start?
The start of what?
Of your career.
Of the career?
Mm-hmm.
It was so long ago that I probably don't remember.
But maybe at the start of your own company?
My own company, finance. Finance is a big problem. You need to have the startup capital to do anything in automotive, and it's not small. Finding the right people is another thing. But I think another struggle was time, because when I was starting the business, I was also working. So it was like double time. You finish on your normal corporate life, mm-hmm. and then rather than go home and sit and relax, you are doing completely different things. With a completely different mindset. So that switch on a daily basis and running this whole thing was quite difficult.
Mm-hmm. And what does the company produce?
We don't produce, we are selling services, and the services automotive projects. so automotive components design, many others, automotive components.
And what makes the company unique? How does it stand out from others?
Yeah, that's the question I really don't like to answer, because I don't know. I think it's people. We've got a great team. The team is very dedicated and experienced. So that's where the expertise is. And you cannot get expertise everywhere, but in most places you can. So I don't think it's a special, it's a unicorn or something completely special. It's a normal, solid company doing what they do, what we do on a daily basis and trying to do the best we can.
And how long did it take you to achieve success?
I didn't achieve it yet. So that's another question which depends how you define success. My success didn't come yet. It's still, I don't think so I will achieve it any time, because it's all about the journey. So if you set your goal which you reach and then you stop and you think it's your success, you're lost. It's a constant chase, and every day marks you the new challenges you need to achieve. So success, you can be a little bit proud maybe, but success is not what we think.
And how do you balance work and family? Do you prefer to stay long hours or maybe spend time with your family?
So of course I prefer to spend time with my family, unless my kids are shouting with each other. But it's difficult. Last 3 years is very difficult, and I struggle to get it balanced, because it's a lot of work. Once you try to set up your own business and you want to do it, you know where you're going, it's hard. My family struggles at the moment, and that's a big fail, I think, from my side. But slowly we'll get that running again.
Yes. And what kind of qualities does a person need to have to set up their own company?
You need to know what you want to do. You need to be persistent. You need to... oh my god, it's a lot. You cannot trust on luck. You need to be prepared. You need to be organized. And definitely you need to be ultra persistent, because you will have a lot of fails at the beginning. And you must not take them personally. Once you set up a business, it's a business, and you try to do it the best you can. So don't take fails inside too much. Try to get it as organized, and try to know what you're doing. Once you need to have also a plan, what you're doing and when.
And do you have to be born with this?
I don't know. Certainly, if you are shy, you don't want to do stuff, you're lazy, then probably you won't achieve too much, unless you've got it granted. But it's 90% in your head, and 90% is knowing what you want to do and how to answer the hard times. Because hard times are coming.
And is it better to work in a team or on your own?
Probably if we would be living in middle ages, you can do stuff by yourself. But right now, you've seen in the office, it's a teamwork, constant team management, team organization. You cannot do stuff with one brain. You need to have plenty of them to do and success.
And what is your motivation for further work?
Well, as I said, it's running through. It's constant challenge. There is the two things. First, you need to... I like to create. I love to create. I absolutely need to build something, otherwise I'm getting angry, bored. You should see me, it's working fast. So, creation. Challenges, I think. That's what I like, that's what I want to do.
And how should someone like you start a business in the future?
In the future? I will tell you my case. In my case, it started with going through a lot of learning, but not learning in school, don't get me wrong. school. What you need to take from school is to where to look for the knowledge, not knowledge itself, because you will explore, but where to look for the knowledge, and then try, then get expertise and get experience in your early career. Find out what you want to do, like where do you feel good, where do you think you struggle, and then it will give you a line, and then you can decide after maybe 2 or 3 years of doing something if you like it or not. But when you choose your career, choose the ways you like. So if you want to do the cars, go to the automotive company. If you want to do the planes, go to the aeroplanes company. If you want to recruit people and build a huge company recruiting people for someone else, go and employ yourself into a recruitment company and see how does it go. And then it will all clarify with once you progress. But there's no like golden receipt for that. It's all up to you.
And do you have a clear plan for the future of the company?
Growth. We want to grow it. We've got a side things we want to do. We want to build our own cars. We've got a lot of things on the plate. But this is a distant future and it's staged. So design, then prototyping, and then maybe something else. But right now, our short and mid-term plan is as we go and grow, accumulate capital, and then spend it on the new streams.
Okay. And the final question is, would you recommend setting up your own company?
Depends on you. It's not for me to answer. You need to answer by yourself. If you want to, it's a sacrifice. Straight away, because your job is not finishing at 6 or at 4, it's a constant work. So if you are prepared for running your own business, and most of the businesses is a hard work, then yes, but it's more gratifying. If it runs, you've got more money than you can ever earn with someone, unless you are ultra skilled professional and you are doing narrow services. But it's completely up to the person. I cannot imagine going back to normal work from 8 till 4 because I would probably die. I need to be in this environment, creating, running, challenging. That's what I am, so that's what I do. But sacrifices you are doing by approaching these things perhaps gets your life in balance, and then once you are mature enough to decide you want to go this way, yes. But there is no problem in setting up something small and trying.
So thank you for your time. It was a pleasure to meet with you and see your company. And we wish you good luck.
Thank you very much. Right?